Morning, everybody. I'm headed out on a little camping trip here in the Carolina Mountains. On the way in here on this dirt road, I spotted some goldenrod here behind me. This one's a pretty big plant. I'll gather some of it for a possible handrail. Then I'm going to get a bunch of the tops and dry it out and make some tea later on. Just going to take my trusty knife here, cut some of these tops off. Get a bunch more of that. I'm going to tie it together. Maybe hang it. Let it dry. Keep some of it for that and then keep some of it for making tea this weekend. I'm going to grab this big stalk. Big enough around to get a handrail out of, looks like it. Yeah, it looks like it. It's not pinky size, but it's pretty close. I'll clean that up. And dry the rest of these and the stalks and use them to make a tripod for the fire. Use about the bottom. I'll leave it there. That'll be my hand drill piece. That'll be plenty. I'll take it up to the campsite. Get a little fire going later on and show you how I make tea.
I want to stop here at this yellow birch tree. There's some great stuff here. This is horse hoof fungus. These big funguses here on the side. This is a great fire starter, fire preserver, fire carrier. It'll keep a coal for you on your travels. They're a little bit tricky to get off the tree. You just kind of push it up and twist out, it'll snap off the tree. This is a dead birch. We'll grab a couple of these. Sometimes they're pretty tough, like that one. Get this big one down here. Horse hoof fungus. I'll take this back to camp. Take these back to camp and show you what you do with them. There's an amadou in the top of these, which is a good fire starter. And also the core. You can saw into the core of these. And the dust will catch a flint and steel spark. I'm also going to get some of this birch bark off this tree. Birch bark has an oil in it on the back side here. Let's just scrape some of this wood off. You scrape it down and build up a good pile of it. It'll also take a spark from a ferro rod. We'll take that back to camp. There's some tinder there on the outside. I'll gather some more of this tinder and I'll see you back at camp. Something you have to remember when you're making curls is all pieces of wood are created equal. When you split a piece and it may have to be turned a certain direction, one end or the other, some of them just won't curl. There are too many grain variances. This one's doing really well. I'm gonna get a bunch of curls up from my fire here. I have some a bit of poplar bark, some old man's beard, and some birch bark. Shavings always help those big flames get going. Alright, one of the neat things about this place I'm camped is there's a lot of quartzite up here. This piece happened to be laying right in the fire pit. There's several pieces laying around here. Alright, let's take a piece of the char cloth. Here on the edge. There we go. If you can see that or not. We'll stick that here in our tinder bundle. If we can blow it into flame and get this fire going. Get some of this birch bark on there. Get it going. Get our curls. Get some sticks on there. Birch bark took off by itself over here. Alright, I'm using a Wolf Creek Forge Striker here today. I have my Altoids 10 with some charred cotton washcloth. I have a piece of flint in there as well. That's what we used to get the fire started today. This Striker just fits in this box. Get it all closed up in there. Goes back in my fire kit. Water should be boiling up here in just a bit. I'm gonna put some goldenrod here in it, and I'll let you know how it does.